Only if the fiercest survive. There are trillions of stars in the cosmos. Each of those stars their own little universe that is identical, yet very different. One realm may even be exactly as yours, except beast and critter alike fight for the survival of the fiercest. This may not change the realm very much at all, save a few subtle differences. However, with such a catastrophic shatter event, it is bound to alter the realm irrevocably. That is the beauty of it all, though. Similar, yet different. Like the hairs of a fur coat. Some hairs are fine and easily move with ease. Others have become matted and tough through much adversity. Even more still, some have become prickly quills to protect themselves from the dangers they encounter each day. I have come to call some of these hairs anomalies, because no matter what realm they exist in, they prevail and dominate. Do not be mistaken. This doesn't mean they find the same path no matter what realm it is, but more that their fundamental core remains intact, even if their coat of fur may have been altered from the bombardment of shatters. One such anomaly is a lovable but fierce bear by the name of Honeycub. In your realm, she's a simple cub scout attempting to be a true forest spirit by showing how fierce she is. However, in another realm, she has become the most fierce through ferocity and cunning. Except not because of determination and spirit, but survival and perseverance. Once more, I find myself in a realm that seems to be broken. As I get my bearings, I notice this place seems to have been beaten and battered to a point that even nature has stayed away. There are signs of fierce battle, but no signs of survivors. Usually I would try to glean what I can from the locals, but It is then I hear in the distance, faintly, the shouts of a crowd in battle. Something fierce and violent. It's still too far for me to walk in a considerable amount of time. I teleport to an area where the noises are significantly louder. A coliseum of sorts. Except this looks to have been made with logs. Like a log cabin? A log coliseum. Interesting. I decided to make my way inside, where I am immediately stopped by a small child.
Hey, you think you can just waltz in here without proving yourself?
I raise my brow at this small child, who keeps punching at the air. I suspect this is some kind of intimidation tactic. I pay it no mind and walk right past the child.
Hey! I said you gotta prove yourself!
I decide to keep walking, but offer a word of advice as I leave. Child, I suggest that you enjoy life as much as you can instead of trying to fight the next challenge. If you give yourself no time to celebrate your victories, the sting of defeat will be that much more painful when you lose. The child yelled back at me, except this one was full of uncertainty and fear.
Hey, mister! Please don't tell anyone that we didn't fight. Can you do that for me?
I didn't quite understand his request yet. Fine. Now run along, child. I have much more important affairs. As I entered the stands, as it were, I noticed that the shouts weren't from the cheering crowd. Rather, I should say, their shouts weren't cheering, but from battle cries as they were fighting each other. As I navigated my way through the chaos, I'm reminded how barbaric lower life forms could be. Violence begets violence. This is how a civilization is led to ruin. Atrocious. As I continue to watch them fight, I notice that in the center of the Colosseum, there is a battle going on. A battle amongst one brutish figure and several combatants. The battle drew my interest. It also was helping clue me in on what the original shatter could be. In the past, I would have written this realm off as being too destructive to exist and erased it from the cosmos. Now, however, I understand that sometimes things beyond their comprehension set them on a course of annihilation. For those that do not know what a shatter is, I shall explain. A shatter is a catastrophic event that occurs in a realm that causes it to be vastly different from the others. From that shatter, cracks can form, and these cracks can form new shatters. However, that is a tale for another time. I have changed my mission to fix these shatters, and if I'm able, find out what is the source of the discourse. For now, though, I'm focusing on shatters so that the lower life forms have a chance to actually live up to their potential.
You see, there is no one more fierce than I, and you proved me right by not being brave enough to best me.
As the gladiator screamed at the top of his lungs, I watched as the entire Colosseum was silenced. I was unaware that they could be placated, let alone be tamed. However, there was one among the crowd that had a strong presence, so much that they all immediately moved out of the way, or rather, shoved each other out of the way. Something about this beast was familiar, and yet they were very different. I watched as they delicately stepped out from the stands and into the center. With a smile, they tossed up their hat.
Someone so pathetic trying to steal my title, I see.
Ha! Your title? And who do you think you are?
He was struck so fast that I needed to slow down time to see what had happened. In an instant, he was punched in the gut, and then hit in the back to straighten him back out.
Yeah, my title of most fierce. You know, if you're gonna take someone's title, you should really learn who they are. What do you have to say for yourself, huh?
Of course, the feeble creature could say nothing, as he was still recovering from the millisecond assault.
Well, that's just rude. When someone asks a question, you're supposed to answer!
Once again, in a flash, the combatant is buried in the ground, underneath a very large crater created from the sheer force of the blow.
Feeling really nice today, so I'll spell it out for you, okay? Make sure you're listening, because it's H-O-N-E-Y-K-U-B. That spells Honeycub, the most fierce.
She catches her hat as it falls back down. It is exactly as I had feared. I make my approach, and I am immediately stopped by the crowd that continues fighting after the cub makes her exit.
Ugh, get out of my way!
It was too late. She was gone. So it seems this honey cub has achieved a dream. She's the most fierce. At what cost? Sometimes if you strive so hard to get something, the cosmos answers you with a caveat. Much like other honey cubs, this one wanting nothing more to be the most fierce. Unlike other honey cubs, it looks like she wasn't going to wait for it to come to her. In doing so, it seems as she has created her own shatter. I'm beginning to realize why that child made me promise that I would tell no one. This is a most severe shatter that could very well develop shatter-forming cracks. If I'm not careful, this can create many more dark realities. I need to find a way to get an audience with the most fierce, but how? As I watch the combatant slowly climb out of the crater, I take a deep breath and know what I must do. I'm sorry, simple creature, but this is in service of something much greater than yourself. On the bright side, you won't be awake to witness the shame of defeat. With that, I lifted the combatant and threw him against the wall. In my most fierce voice, which wasn't very fierce, I made an open challenge. You all are playing a fool's game. To win a prize you will never even come close to in your lifetime. Simpletons. How about you stop quarreling with each other, and work together to take down those that are too big for you individually? Once more, the Colosseum grew silent. It was as if cooperation was a foreign concept to them. They stood dumbfounded until I spoke again. Of course, you only understand violence. Very well then, here we go. I lifted one of the smaller creatures and threw them at a much larger creature. Yet it was with enough force that the larger creature fell to the ground. As if a spark went off in their feeble minds, they all came after me, some even attempting to copy what I had done by throwing others in my direction. I snapped my fingers and stopped time, moved from my current position, and snapped time back. I watched as every combatant fell unconscious as they rammed into each other, attempting to hit an opponent that wasn't there. Bested by simple physics, Every action has an equal but opposite reaction. Since the only thing that was going to stop you was each other, then all I needed was to get you to exert enough force to knock each other out. I suppose this would make me the most fierce, wouldn't you agree? They listened to the groans of the crowd. I waited for her to return, except she didn't make an appearance. I would have surely thought that would have worked. What am I missing? I decided to leave the Colosseum to find out what I was missing. Before I left, I saw the child again.
Hey, mister!
When I stopped to look at him, he flinched. Believe it or not, I'm not going to hurt you. This isn't my intention. This is far more interfering than I was wanting to do. The child, slowly, very slowly, lowered their guard.
Are you sure, mister?
Got down to his level and tried my best to give a smile. Yes, I'm sure. I don't interfere unless I have to. The child laughed at my ridiculous attempt at smiling.
Well, you should work on your smile more, mister. It looks more like a scowl to me.
You're right. But I don't smile at a lot of things. Smiling is, well, difficult for me. The child began to frown.
Isn't there anything that makes you happy? As long as you have that, you'll be right as rain. Not that rain is right. Well, I mean it sometimes is. It's nice to fall asleep to the sound. Until the thunder, of course. Then it gets really scary. Sometimes I try to find a place I can hide while it goes away.
I try to smile again, and the best I can give is a half-hearted smirk. Sometimes thinking of happy things is a little hard. And you know there are so many sad things, too. Just like your rain and thunder. I open my eyes wide as I suddenly know how to find Honeycup. Child, you said you hide when you hear thunder. Where do you hide? The child takes a moment to think, and then takes my hand to show me a tall mountain.
At Mount Fierce, there are a lot of good hiding spots, like hollowed out trees or rocks to hide behind, or...
I look at the very top and see what looks like a bear's head almost. Caves. The child lets go of my hand and shakes in fear.
Yeah, like caves. I try not to go there, unless I'm really, really scared. That's where the bears go, and they're the most...
Fierce. I know, child. I know quite a lot about bears. It's just like any other beast. They aren't something to be feared, but revered. They can be strong and even fierce. But they can also be kind and caring. Protective. Some see this as wrongfully as terror, intimidation, and brutality, but that is far from the truth. To be fierce is to be courageous and show others that it's okay to be afraid, even though you are protecting others. Showing others that being afraid isn't a weakness, but a strength that helps you understand danger. Thank you, child. Now go and hide in a safe space until the thunder goes away. I watch the child scurry to wherever it is they feel safe. Which is what Honeycup is probably doing right now. I trekked all the way to the top of Mount Fierce, to the Bearmouth Cave. It was as I expected. I found an adorable Cub Scout playing with stuffed animals. They were playing as a child would when they have no one else to play with. When they have to be brave for themselves. When they believe they have to be the most fierce. I came to see the most fierce, but that's not what I see here. Suddenly, Honeycup throws her stuffed animals aside, and with lightning speed has a dagger at my throat. She stops.
You know, if I wanted to end you, I could have done it. I'm in a good mood right now, though, so you're lucky. Do you know who I am?
I let out a small laugh as I watched her begin to back off. Yes. The most fierce. H-O-N-E-Y-K-U-B. Honeycup. I know who you are, just like I know every other honeycup. Clearly the mention of other honeycup only frustrates her more.
Well, I'm the fiercest of them all.
I looked at the stuffed animal and smirked. As they are all too. Fierceness can mean a lot of different things to different bears. Did you find this cave all by yourself? I watch as she picked up her stuffed animals and tries to throw them behind a large rock.
Yes, by myself. Can the other honey cubs do that? I don't think so.
Deep down, she's still like the rest of them. Thankfully. No, I can't say that many of them would be able to do the same. Of course, some of them don't need to do that. Then again, they aren't the most fierce yet. Some still have a lot of learning to do. Some are learning what true fierceness is. And some are redefining what fierceness means. Some are finding out that being fierce doesn't mean anything if you don't have friends or family to protect. I struck a nerve.
Oh, so that's what you think. I need to be fierce because I don't have anyone. Oh, boo-hoo. Lonely little honeycup climbing up a mountain all by herself because there isn't anyone else around to save her. Boo-hoo. Poor honeycup. Nobody cares because you can't even protect yourself. Poor honey. Honey.
I can hear the sadness in her voice. I close my eyes and do something that I rarely do.
What are you doing? Get away from me! Let go! Stop it! I'm the most fierce!
As I close the bear hug, I let her continue to yell.
I can take care of myself! I'm the most fierce! They all fear me now! I'm not lonely! I choose to be alone! No one is more fierce than me! No one!
I take deep breaths as she continues to yell. It's okay. I know that you're the most fierce. It's okay. You don't need to prove anything to me. You're very strong and very brave. You're exactly what a bear spirit should be. You are so amazing. I grow a little concerned as she gets quiet. Then, after a whimper, she lets it all out.
Why didn't anyone want to be my friend? Why was I alone? Why didn't anyone want to protect me?
I start to comfort her as I realize that just like all the other honey cub, deep down, she isn't a mean bear. She was a bear that was determined to be the most fierce so that no one would feel as helpless as she did when she had to find shelter in the Bear Mouth Cave by herself. Somewhere along the way, though, she lost sight of her true goal. All she knew was that nothing else mattered except being the most fierce. I understand the shatter now. Honey cub, I know you want everyone to feel like they don't have to be helpless when they are alone, and that they are strong all their own. However, I think in your quest to become the most fierce, you made the others believe that they too had to show they were not weak, that they had to prove they were more fierce than the rest, so much that they became violent. But violence only begets violence. A very hard cycle to break. I think I know how, though. Will you help me? Honeycub wiped her tears away and put on her bravest face.
Yes, I will be the most fierce and show them a better way.
And so, as the clouds began to clear and the thunder went away, we went down Mount Fierce towards the Colosseum. The crowd had recovered from their previous altercation and were once again at each other's throats. I waited for Honeycub to address them.
All those who are not the most fierce, cease your fighting this instant. I have something to say.
Once more, the crowd stopped immediately. They all waited to hear what the most fierce had to say as she stood in the center of the Colosseum.
I thought that being the most fierce meant being able to take on an opponent with ease. And for everyone to fear me, I was wrong.
The crowd gasped in unison. Disbelief.
Fierceness isn't based on how strong you are or how scary you can be. Fierceness is how brave you can be for others when they find it hard to find the courage inside themselves. Fierceness is being able to protect those that are weak because you are strong. Fierceness is showing others that they too can be brave if they believe in themselves.
There was no one in the crowd that could respond. Except one. The combatant that had been beaten previously. Multiple times, I may add.
Ha! Did you hear all that? Only someone that was weak would say something so stupid. Most fierce. I think you should be called the most stupid.
I could see Honeycup's eyes quickly change to that of an apex predator. I feared that this insignificant cur was about to undo Honeycup's progress. Honeycup, don't stoop to his level. You don't have to prove yourself to him or anyone else. It was no use. Honeycup, in an instant, had the wretch in her hands.
Most stupid, huh? Okay then, why don't we prove who is the most stupid and the most fierce?
She picked up the cur and stood him up on his own 2 feet. Then she did something no one had expected. Something I did not expect.
Thumb war.
The cur had no idea what to do as she outstretched her hand in the ready position for a thumb war.
Oh, come on. You don't know what a thumb war is?
She grabs his hand and puts it in hers and then begins explaining the rules.
Okay, so we lock hands and then with our thumbs count to 10 like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, I declare a thumb war. Then the first one to pin their opponent for 10 seconds wins the thumb war.
While the cur still didn't quite understand, he still played the game. She starts the count.
1, 2, 3, 4, I declare a thumb war.
The cur and Honeycub battled fiercely until the cur's thumb slips and Honeycub finds her opening. She has a strong grip on her opponent.
Well, looks like I gotcha, you wily rascal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I win the thumb war! Yay!
The cur, still a bit confused, is also upset that he lost.
Very well. Maybe you aren't the most stupid. I demand a rematch.
Honeycub smirks as she outstretches her hand again.
Oh, do you now? All right, I won't be going easy on you this time.
She wins effortlessly again, but that isn't what is important. What is important is that cur bows and then kneels, not out of fear, but out of reverence and respect.
You are the winner, and rightfully the most fierce, Miss Honeycub.
I watch as Honeycub has the first real smile on her face since I got to this realm.
It's just Honeycub. You don't need to spell it out every time. Keep training and practicing, friend. Maybe one day you'll win too.
The beast stood up and also smiled.
I would like that very much. I shall train and practice until I am strong enough to win this thumb war. I will show others that they too can be fierce, and maybe one day even win their very own thumb wars. I better start training right now.
The crowd that was silent up until now begins to roar with, finally, the sounds of cheering. Actual, genuine cheering. With that, Kenitsuki has been performed, and the cracks have been repaired. Honeycub looks at me and has a smirk on her face. She stretches her hand out.
Oh, don't think you're getting away that easily, bear. I saw the old cave drawings. You're not just any bear, or should I call you by your old name? Oh, Baron?
I can't help but smirk as I shake her outstretched hand. Nowadays they call me Omni. And thank you for showing me that even a bear can learn new tricks. I raise a brow as he doesn't let go of my hand. As I start to motion to get her to let go, I can feel her grip tighten. I exhale. If you know my old name, then you must also know that it isn't a good idea to make me angry. Again, her grip tightens, but this time with her other hand, she brings up one of her stuffed bears. She then finally lets go as she makes me cradle the stuffed bear.
I know. I also know that you must be very lonely being the only one of your kind. I know. I've been there. Maybe too many times. Then a nice sweet bear came to save me and showed me that I don't have to be alone. that sometimes all it takes is one friend. So here you go, Mr. Bear. A friend for you.
I look down at the bear and begin to genuinely smile. Something that I don't do a lot of. Just like all the other honey cub, your kindness and compassion still outshines any fierceness. Thank you for being a friend. Is there anything you would like me to tell the other honeycombs that I may encounter in my travels? Some that may perhaps be so alone, also alone and may be afraid? Honeycub looks the teddy bear in the eye and begins to hold it in my hands.
I want you to tell any honeycub that may be trying to be the most fierce that it's okay if fierce doesn't look mean and scary. That isn't what being fierce is all about. It's about being brave for others, and showing them that they too can be strong. To those that may be alone or afraid, let them know that it's okay to feel that too, but that there are others they can reach out to, and that it's okay to make friends. It can be hard, but you'll eventually get there, and that's coming from another honey cub, so I totally understand how hard it can get.
Before I snap myself to the next realm in need of help, I smile at Honeycup with her teddy bear in my arm. Thank you, Honeycup. I will definitely make sure that any other Honeycup I encounter know who the most fierce is. May you enjoy your newfound happiness. And so ends our tale of how the most fierce truly became the most fierce.